DNA is a real deal.
23 pairs of chromosomes make up our DNA, the person we are. But what if some of those chromosomes were question marks?
And then you open up Pandora's box.
It's amazing and deeply troubling what a local woman uncovered about her family.
Are you freaking out?
After taking a simple DNA test.
I see you!
As she learns more about her own background, questions are answered.
And then it's like the most icky feeling because that person was something that was a part of who, like what created you.
DNA discoveries, opening a world she never expected.
I'm super scared about what we could potentially uncover because I don't think that she and I are the only ones out there.
I'm Matt Fleener. More than 26 million people took a home DNA test in 2018. Many have had happy reunions with long-lost family.
But look closely at the fine print for one of those tests. You might discover unanticipated facts about yourself you may not have the ability to change.
Melissa Blayton is living proof of that. Adopted as a baby, she's had questions about her family history her entire life. But her DNA journey started with just one. Who am I?
I like to start with eyes first, and that is because you're gonna make a mess with all of your eyeshadow. So we want to perfect that.
Melissa Blayton transforms others as a professional makeup artist in Kansas City's Northland.
It's transforming inside, and they walk differently, they talk differently.
She's an expert helping others feel beautiful on the outside.
I mean, my grandmother always said, lashes and lips make a lady.
But under the surface, Melissa always felt a strong urge to answer questions about herself that have lingered for years.
I have had to, you know, look in the mirror and figure out what the heck was, you know, who are you? You know, not knowing anything about where you come from.
Born in May 1973 in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, Melissa somehow ended up in San Antonio, Texas as a baby. Told that's where her birth mother gave her up for adoption.
I was pretty darn cute. So I would have been, I'm just saying, like that had to be tough for her.
She was adopted by loving parents in San Antonio, who as they were finalizing her adoption, found out they would have a biological son named Rob.
I hit the jackpot. Like, they are the best ever.
A picture-perfect family until Melissa's brother Rob died unexpectedly. The loss triggering the need to investigate her own life story and answer that question she carried for years. Who am I?
It really became more needed for me when I lost my brother in 2017, and just like realizing there's no siblings left. It was just he and I.
Since Melissa knew she was adopted, she turned to a home DNA test from Ancestry.com. Would her DNA, she wondered, reveal any other family members out there? The test, as easy as spinning in a tube. Melissa sending her DNA sample off to Ancestry.
For me, it was like spinning into this little tube was going to connect me with somebody. And I honestly thought, I'm gonna find a cousin.
Weeks later, she received a report containing hundreds of clues.
When you find out something that hits closer to home, I think that helps to open your eyes a little bit more and provide you with a greater understanding of your place in the world.
Nearly 1 in 25 Americans paid to take a home DNA test in 2018. Their most intimate genetic information stored in centralized online databases like 23andMe and Ancestry.com.
Our expansive record collections and growing network of family trees have helped our members make billions of meaningful connections. Those are more than names and dates. They're relatives, homes, hardships, and triumphs.
DNA has connected thousands of biological sons, daughters, mothers, and fathers, and other family. Melissa wondered if that could happen for her too.
Possibly to connect with the woman who gave birth to me, just to tell her thank you for letting me hit the jackpot with the most amazing family. But it wasn't about that. It was just about finding a cousin or a sister or a brother that I could say, there you go, you're like me too.
she didn't have to wait long until a message on Ancestry.
That would be Caitlin.
Doing what many of us would do, Melissa looked up Caitlin on Facebook.
I'm like, she looks like me. So I clicked on her profile.
They started chatting. Melissa soon learned Caitlin was 17 and living in Florida. Their DNA match on Ancestry revealed they could be cousins.
I happened to post on my Facebook page that, oh my gosh, I found a first cousin. I'm so excited. And somebody tagged another person who does this for a living.
And that's the great thing now is that we do have DNA.
That person, Connie Gray, a search angel living south of Austin, Texas. As a search angel, Connie volunteers her time connecting families through DNA matches online.
Unfortunately, for so many adoptees, the records are closed.
Connie asked Melissa and Caitlin to send her their DNA raw data reports. After just weeks of investigating, she found the two women were not cousins after all.
She's like, you guys are actually sisters. And a lot of other words came out. And I immediately called her. I was like, you better not be freaking lying because she's 17 years old. This is not a game.
A DNA match Connie found showed Caitlin and Melissa had the same father, but different mothers. But what should have been happy news quickly took a turn for the worse. Caitlin, Melissa's new sister, had something to tell her.
And she explains to me that her mother was raped and left for dead in a dumpster and was so unrecognizable they didn't know who she was for days. And that's how she was conceived. And I'm like, oh, I'm so sorry that happened to your mother.
Caitlin never knew her father, but always believed she was born out of her mother's rape. That information raising more questions for Melissa. If her father had sexually assaulted Caitlin's mother, had he done the same thing to her own mother 27 years earlier? So she questioned even deeper, just who is her biological father?
And then you open up Pandora's box, and then it's like the most icky feeling because that person was something that was a part of who, like, what created you.
That's when Melissa reached out to KMBC 9 Chronicle with the warning those home DNA kits hold much more power than people realize.
My wife and I.
Melissa wanted to use her story to prepare others for what they could find.
How are you supposed to comprehend and process that everything that you're hoping to find, and then you find something out like that?
Melissa and Caitlin found each other online, but they still had not met.
Keep walking, just follow the people.
Could being together in person
I see you.
answer more questions about their biological father?
What's really important is finding out, is he still out there?
And what about Melissa's biological mother? More discoveries hiding in Melissa's DNA about to be revealed.
Hurricane Michael intensifying in the Florida Panhandle, preparing for a monster storm.
October 9th, 2018. Hurricane Michael is barreling down on the Florida coast.
Is that the gate?
At Kansas City International Airport. One of the last flights to leave Florida before the hurricane has just pulled up to the gate. Where Melissa Blayton is waiting to meet her sister, Caitlin. They had met just a few months before online. A DNA test through Ancestry.com confirmed they're half-sisters. They had the same father, but different mothers. They were also born 27 years apart.
I get to meet my baby sister, and I feel like she's my daughter. It's kind of weird, like, my daughter's coming home. But yeah, we never met. And She's 17 years old. She could be my child.
Melissa is 45. Caitlin, 17. Melissa discovered Caitlin was living with her aunt after moving around a lot as a child.
For all intents and purposes, she's been basically living in a foster situation. Somebody who's been taking great care of her. And now I get to meet her and kind of be that person to her, like unconditional love and a family member. Walk in, just follow the people.
Just a few minutes after the plane's arrival.
I see you.
How true that statement would become when Melissa saw Caitlin in person for the first time.
Hi.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my god.
Can you believe it's real?
Hi, oh my god.
So began what they thought was a weekend visit.
We're gonna go, we're gonna go.
If you don't follow our warnings from officials, this storm could kill you.
But the plan changed when the hurricane damaged Caitlin's aunt's house where she'd been staying in Florida. Going back was no longer an option.
She was here because of the hurricane.
Right.
So now she's here. We're good.
1 month after they first met.
Definitely better than Florida.
Caitlin had moved to Kansas City.
So the weirdest thing to find out was when she and I first started talking was that she's like, so good at makeup naturally.
Caitlin started working in Melissa's makeup studio.
Happy birthday.
It looks so good.
She got her own room in Melissa's house.
What do you think?
I'm crying.
Like, the inside is pretty clean.
She got a new SUV to get around too.
She's in pretty good condition for what we paid for her. We just had to replace the brakes.
But as the next chapter in their lives began, they couldn't ignore the questions still lingering about how their lives began.
Well, my mom always said that she was like brutally like raped and beaten and like left for dead. And that's just what I've been told.
Melissa and Caitlin are connected through their biological father's DNA. If Caitlin was born as a result of rape, they couldn't help but wonder if Melissa was too.
I've known for a while, so it's like, that's just like what I know about it. So I've kind of like had time to, you know, accept it and deal with it. Melissa just found out that information.
DNA had forced this painful question for Melissa. Who was the man who brought her into this world?
How do you prepare yourself? Well, just in case I find my parent and he's a rapist. Like, how do you prepare yourself for that? Like, you don't. Like, I don't know. But I don't have any regrets because I'm so thankful to have found her.
Melissa and Caitlin have each other, but still don't know the real truth about their father. And since sharing their story, it's brought up very tough conversations about him with other family members, forcing these secret family histories wide open.
An average person could take this test and find out all this crazy stuff.
I hope he is not that person that she's been told he was. And maybe he just doesn't know about her. And maybe he's a decent person and she could have a relationship. She's never had that.
For now, the question of who is Melissa and Caitlin's biological father remains unanswered. But could DNA help Melissa find her biological mother who gave her up for adoption?
I've had this desire and longing to just want to meet my birth mother and tell her thank you. You know, thank you for giving me such a great life because I've had the coolest parents ever.
I was able to find two distinct lines on her mother.
Melissa's volunteer search angel, Connie Gray, spent weeks researching Melissa's DNA history.
All right, so let me see if I could just...
KMBC 9 Chronicle was there as Connie revealed another discovery that would once again change Melissa's life.
Hi, Matt.
Hey, Connie. I'm just going to let you two talk, and Connie, can you just share what you have found in her DNA profile?
Sure.
Okay.
It would have been great if Melissa could have gone to the state of North Carolina and been given her original birth certificate that had her mother's name on it. How easy would that have been? Unfortunately, she didn't have that. But you know what? We've got something better. We've got DNA.
Connie had used Melissa's DNA profile to search the family trees of Melissa's closest DNA matches.
I was able to ultimately identify the woman who I suspected was your biological mother. And her name was Donna Kay. Unfortunately, she had passed away. Okay. However, I was able to identify two daughters of hers through different social media. I reached out, and ultimately, one of them did contact me back. Now, you had told me when you were in foster care that the foster mother had told you that your name at that time was Candace.
Yeah,
right,
that's
now.
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that was the one clue that we had. We didn't have anything else to go on. And when I reached out to one of the sisters.
That sister, the second connected to Melissa, lives in Texas. Her name, Cynthia.
One of the first things she said to me was, "Are you contacting me about Candace?" I met with her. I gave her a DNA kit. And it came back that yes, you and Cynthia are half sisters. Your mother is Donna Kay. She's been very excited about this process, and she's really looking forward to meeting you. Are you ready to meet her?
Yeah, of course.
Here's your sister, Cynthia.
Hi.
Hi.
So you knew about me.
I didn't know 100%. I just knew that there was somebody out there that my mother, I just know Candace. I just knew that there was somebody Candace, and my mother told me when I was very, very, very young, but that was it. She just never told me anything.
Melissa was actually named Candace at birth. She had been given up for adoption in Texas. Turns out Cynthia had been too. Their biological mother, Cynthia says, spent years in and out of prison. She died in 2013.
How did she pass away, though? What caused her to pass away?
She had, Connie said it best, she had a hole within her that could never be filled.
You know, it's crazy. Is I've always felt like if I ever found out anything about her, she probably took her own life. And I've always felt that. And I don't know why, but that's something that I've kind of felt like would be what I found out.
Cynthia says their biological mother had overdosed. It wasn't the news Melissa had hoped for, but at least she now knew.
I suffer from anxiety and depression, and I suspected that probably, you know, obviously comes from somewhere, and clearly she did too, and it got the best of her. And, you know, we have to make sure, you know, I talk very openly, you know, through my social media about how people don't need to feel bad about needing help. And now we have each other, and we don't have to get into that dark place that she got to.
Since that meeting, Melissa still does not know what happened between her biological father, the one with the criminal past, and her biological mother. But she's pursuing other family connections through DNA to figure out that mystery.
Melissa and her newly found sister, Cynthia, have agreed to meet in person to learn more about their biological mother. Melissa says the third sister besides Cynthia and Caitlin, whom she also learned about through DNA, will also meet with them too. Recognizing these discoveries aren't easy.
This is Adam.
Hey, Adam, it's Melissa.
Meanwhile, Caitlin, the sister who moved in with Melissa after finding out they had the same father.
I was wondering what would be available to me.
Is now getting ready to move out.
And then she's going to be on campus next Friday.
But before she does, a final question. Do they have any regrets about taking the DNA test that started it all?
There's no book that can freaking prepare you.
And what Melissa wants you to know before taking a DNA test.
Maybe we should write a book about
it. Of your own.
Like, how to freaking prepare yourself.
This is Adam.
Hey, Adam, it's Melissa. I have you on speakerphone, and I'm here with my sister, Caitlin.
It's late March 2019.
Hi, Caitlin.
Hi.
The time when high school seniors make calls to prepare for college.
And then she says she uploaded her test score.
For Melissa Blayton and Caitlin Pate, these normal family experiences are completely new.
I think the hardest thing has been, how do we build a sister relationship and be sisters when it's like I'm a parent role too?
6 months ago, the two didn't even know the other existed. Now, they're connected as sisters after taking an at-home DNA test.
I kind of told you a little bit about our story and how the Ancestry DNA connected us as she was searching for more information about her heritage for some potential scholarship money.
Caitlin, through her test results, learned she has several different ethnicities making up her DNA. She also found a half-sister she never knew. Now living together, both women say their lives have changed forever.
I mean, we learn new things about each other like all the time.
She's an awesome kid. You know, I got lucky. She's not like this troubled teenager.
Even though they're almost 30 years apart, they've begun to realize just how similar they are. DNA proves it, and they're starting to believe it.
There's no book that can freaking prepare you.
It's a pretty unique situation.
Super unique situation, and maybe we should write a book about it. Like, how to freaking prepare yourself. because I don't think you can.
They've discovered their shared biological father may have had a criminal past. Melissa's biological mother, she's learned, intentionally overdosed and died in 2013. So knowing what Melissa knows now, would she do it all over again?
Yeah, I would definitely would. I feel like even the not so awesome stuff that I found out, and I think on the birth mom side, you know, finding truths out and still learning about our birth father.
Yeah.
I mean, I have her, you know, like I wouldn't have met her had I not done this.
Caitlin says she would take that test all over again too.
I don't realize how weird it is until I tell people about it. Wow. Like, I don't know, like, I've never really had a normal life. So, I mean, yeah, it's like been really crazy, like going through all of it, but I don't realize how like normal everybody else's lives are until I tell them what's going on and they're like, what?
As millions of people around the world continue to make unbelievable DNA discoveries, what's normal may continue to be challenged. Online DNA support groups are becoming more popular. People with pain, confusion, and questions that are coming up. Ancestry.com told KMBC 9 Chronicle it takes the potential impact of DNA discoveries very seriously. It has a small team dedicated to people with more sensitive queries.
I'm living my life as authentically for me and not for anybody's approval.
And Melissa wants us all to remember that fine print. You could learn unanticipated facts you may not have the ability to change.
Because I think we're all a little bit of a hot mess.
Melissa's joined a few support groups and sees a life coach too.
I feel like everybody needs a rub up in their wardrobe.
After transforming people through makeup for so many years.
Smile.
This deeper look into herself through DNA has radically transformed her from the inside out.
From as small as a child to, you know, even as an adult, you just want to be accepted. You want to fit in, and it's true. And I have to remind myself, like, no, you know, don't try to fit in. Work hard to stand out and be yourself. And I've had to work so hard to really figure out who I am without knowing where I came from, that I think the journey has really allowed me to just be comfortable in me.
Thanks for joining us on this KMBC 9 Chronicle DNA Discoveries. If you've taken a home DNA test and maybe need some extra counseling, we have some resources on KMBC.com. We also have some extra interviews with Melissa about this entire DNA journey. We leave you tonight with a letter Melissa has written to her new sisters she's found through DNA.
to my lovely sisters. Okay, it really does take me back to be able to even say the word sister. And now there isn't just one of you, but there's three of you. It's still so surreal and feels like a dream. This has been a journey that none of us could have ever prepared and been prepared for, but one that I'm so thankful for. I love each of you so much, and I truly look forward to whatever the future holds for us.